me, Shambhavi. Hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to make a stopwatch with the help of Python programming language. This is the final stopwatch. This is the kind of a stopwatch that will be coming as the final output for us. Now, basically what will be happening here as I just click on the start. So basically my seconds will actually start, right? They will just start moving. After that, basically I will be having the options for the pause. I will be having the options for the reset. And even I'll be having the app option for the exit button, right? If I just click on pause, so just have a look that it at this particular time, my stopwatch has been stopped, right? Other than that, if we just click on the reset button, so just see that my time has been reset here. And if I click on the exit, so my stopwatch has been exit, right? So this is the whole idea of the project that we are gonna make today, right? So basically, this project is actually made with the help of the tkinter library, okay? Tkinter is a library that we'll be using for making out this project. And rest other things that, what are the other things that we'll be using, that will be let you know in the project itself. Without wasting time, let's get started with that. So, as soon as I'm just going to use out my tkinter library, so my very first step is that I need to import that out, right? So I'm writing import tkinter as, and here be tk, right? So this means that I'm importing my tk into library and giving it a short form as tk. So wherever I just use tk, that will actually directly refer to my tk into library. Okay, now I'll be making this project, this stopwatch project, with the help of the classes topic which we have in Python programming. Okay, so for this I'll be defining a class, and after that I'll be defining the functions. And basically that functions will be performing the whole work that you have just seen on the output window, right? So first of all, let me just define a class, and that class would be stopwatch. Let's say the name for my class is stopwatch, okay? And in the bracket, basically I'll be passing out the tk dot frame, okay? So the frame for tk I'll be passing out, because what I just want is that I want that whatever the things, whatever the functions I apply here, all those should act upon the basic tkinter window that we are going to make, right? So in that case, I just pass tk.frame inside the bracket right here. Now basically I'll be defining out my init function here. So def underscore underscore init underscore, and in brackets here I'll be writing the self. So self, basically if it is using any IDE or something like that, so in that basically self will automatically be passed inside this, but I'm using the Sublime Text editor, so in that I just need to write out, right? And basically I'd be giving out a parameter that is window, okay? Window is equal to, and I'll be writing here as none, okay? That why I have just written, I'll be explaining that thing in a little while, right? Now basically what I just want is that inside this I'll be defining a method, and that method is actually called as super, okay? Super is actually one method which we define here, and I would be initializing with the help of init, right? And in the bracket I'll be passing out that window which we have written here. So that is like right this, okay? That is window here, right? It is actually done. Now what I just need to do is that I need to come, okay, I need to come here, and I need to define several variables that I'll be using in my whole program, okay? I'll be defining that several variables that I would be using. So that is a first variable is my window that I'll be using. Window is actually referring to the tkinter window that we are going to make, right? That will be appearing. It is referring to that tkinter window, okay? So this window is done. Next, basically, I'll be passing here an okay. One another thing, that whatever the variables you'll be making here, you'll be making all the variables with the help of the self word only. That is self. Okay, anytime self are actually a type of constructors actually, okay? We just use them in making the class and object, and they basically are used as a constructors, okay? So in that case, I'd be using the self constructor each and everywhere, wherever I'd be using and making my any of the variables. So this window is actually a variable which I am making, okay? So in that case, I'm just using the self variable. Now, sorry, the self constructor. Other than that, I would be making my several more variables. In that itself, I'd be using this self constructor, okay? So my next variable is new underscore time, okay? New time, and I'll be putting out the semicolon. I'll be keeping it blank here, because this thing I'll be using out in the reset button, okay? After that, I would be writing here self dot, and here I'll be using running, okay? And that I'll be giving here as false, okay? That is F-A-L-S-C. Okay, just one second. Let me just write out this thing, right? Other than this, I'll be taking the total hours, total minutes, and total seconds, and I'll be initializing all the three as zero because I'll be incrementing them inside the function where I'll be applying that, right? So first of all, I need to keep them as zero. So for, I'll be writing self dot, and I'll be writing here total underscore hours. Okay, self dot total underscore hours is equal to, and I'll be giving the value as zero. Same thing I'll be applying for total underscore minutes. That is minutes, and that will also be equal to zero. And after this, it would be self dot total underscore second, and this also I'll be initializing at zero. And wherever I'd be just defining the functions for the hours, minutes, and totals, then I'll be applying the increment operator so as to increase these values as soon as my watch goes on. Right? This is the whole idea on defining these defining these variables. Right? And after that, I'll be even using one function which is pack. I just like this pack function actually used to apply all of the things whichever we are just writing onto that tkinter window. Okay, and I would be defining one function here that is, okay, let me just not define that function for now. I'll be defining it afterwards. Okay, that is self.features actually. Okay, I'm defining that features function, and that I'll be making and defining afterwards. So after this, what I'll be doing is that I'll be taking the root. Root is basically my variable in which I'll be storing my tkinter window, right? So root is equal to tk dot. This tk is a short form which we have given to the tkinter library. Okay, so this will be in short. I'll be putting out a dot here. After that, I'll be applying a capital T. Now this capital T and small k, this is actually referring to my tkinter window that will actually be made. Okay, after this, I would not be writing anything, and simply I'll be giving out the object for my class. Okay, so the object for my class is obj. Let's say I just make the object for my class, that is obj, right? OBJ is equal to, and the name for my classes is stop watch, right? And in the bracket, here bracket, I'll be passing window is equal to, and I'm writing it as root, okay? Because this root here it comes. So I had taken this window parameter inside my init constructor, right? That is why I'm just writing here window is equal to root. And why I'm just writing root? Because in root, root is the variable in which I have stored my tkinter window, right? This is the whole idea, and at class I'm just writing obj dot main loop, and I'm just closing it. Right, this is the closing of the program. Now, next thing that I would be doing here is that I would be passing here that self dot features function, and now I'd be defining a function that is called as features. Okay, so I'd be writing here self dot fe that is features, and we're putting out the bracket here. Now, coming here and just go one step back. I'll be remaining inside my class only. Just have a look that whatever the functions I'll be defining right now, whatever I will be writing, all of that things will be coming inside my class only. But the thing is that I'll not be writing it inside my init constructor. I'll be writing it inside the class. So that is why I'm going to define my function here. Okay, let me just go one step down. So the name for my function is features. Now, what I'd be storing into this features function? First of all, inside pass self. Okay, do not forget to pass the self inside the functions, because in basically classes, what we do whenever we just make a function, a method, actually inside the classes we just do not call as these functions, we just call them as methods, that I am making a method. Okay, so whenever we just make these methods, so inside the methods, this self is automatically always passed because you are defining this method inside the class. Okay, this is the idea. If you are using any IDE, let's say PyCharm or VS Code or anything else, then the self will automatically be passed. You do not need to write it here. Okay, see, I'm just using the Sublime Text. So basically, I need to use it. I need to write it manually. Otherwise, if you're using any IDE, it will be passed automatically. Okay, come on to the next line. Now, inside this features, I am going to define all the buttons which I want. That is basically my start, stop, reset, and exit. All those four buttons I'm going to define. Other than that, I'm defining that basically what format of time I want. See, basically there you will see that it is 00:00:00, right? This was the format of the time which was appeared. So I'm just going to define this format only inside this features function, and all the buttons I'm going to define, right? What background color, what foreground color I want, all those things will be written inside this features function, right? So let me start here. So I'll be writing self dot and that would be stopwatch underscore label. This will be basically giving me the label that what I need to write in the stopwatch and basically what are the things that I want. So I'll be writing here tk dot label. So first of all, I'll be using label because I want to do some features. I want to apply some features onto that time which will be appearing, right? So inside the bracket, first I'll be passing out the cells, comma. Now, what type of text actually I want here? What text should be coming? So that would be 00 colon 00 colon 00, right? This was the format in which we want the time to appear. Now, you can just change out the format. Let's say you just want 0 colon 0 colon 0. So you can just write that also. Okay, it depends on you. So right now here, I'm just writing that thing. Other than that, I want to get a background color. For that, I'm just passing here background is equal to. And let's say my background was black, right? So I'm just writing here as black. Other than that, now I have another parameter that is foreground. Now, what is this foreground used? So this foreground is actually used that what text color actually you want. So I have made my background color as black. So I'll be wanting out my text color as white, right? So I've been writing here as white. Okay, I'll be putting a comma here. And what type of font actually you want? Do you want to give a particular font style? You want to give a particular size? You want to give a particular, let's say, bold, italic, or something like that? Okay, so inside this font, I'll be writing all those things. So let's say my basically which I just want is Arial. Okay, the size should be, let's say, I want it to be 85. Okay, and other than that, I want it to be bold, right? These are the features which I just want to add on to that stopwatch that will be appearing, right? So all of them I have just written here. Now I'll be coming on to the next line. Okay, let me just go back and show you right here. Now basically I'll be using cells dot, and that would be stopwatch underscore label, my variable which I had made this one. And I'd be using dot pack here. So dot pack, why I have used? So as to apply all of these features onto my window. And this was the reason that I have declared my pack function here. Okay, now just got the idea. Come on to the next line. Here basically I would be defining the start time button. Okay, I'd be giving the button for my start time. So self dot, I'd be writing self dot, the variable name which I just want to give here is start underscore time underscore button, start time button. Okay, now please make sure to listen to me very carefully that I'll be writing tk dot, but instead of label I'll be writing button. I would not be writing the label here. Why? Because I want a button to appear. I do not want any features, any enhancement to be added on that tk inter window. Now on that tk inter window, I just want a button, and all those features should act upon that button. Okay, so in that case, I'm just writing here as tk dot button. Okay, then I'll be writing here self comma. Now what text will be coming here? So my text would be start. Okay, just let me just come down so that it's more visible. So my text would be start, let's say. Okay, this capital one. Other than this, what I just want here is that what should be the height of that button that will be coming. Okay, height and width of that button. So height of that button, okay, height of that button would be, let's say, 5. Okay, and let's say the width of that button would be, let's say, 7. Okay, height would be 5 and width would be 7, let's say. Other than that, basically, what will be the font? So, font is equal to bracket, and font I'll be keeping as same, which is Arial. The size of that font would be, let's say, 19. And other than that, I just want it to be bold as well. So, I'll be writing here as bold. Now, after that, basically, I just want to give some background color as well to it, right? So I'd be writing here background is equal to, and my background color will be here. Okay, just one second, let me just close out this bracket here. Now it's okay. So my background color would be, for my start button, let's say I just want the background color to be green, right? Other than that, okay, we have one more parameter to add here, but that I would not be doing here. That I'd be doing afterwards when I would be just defining the functions for all of these things. Then I'd be writing out that command. Okay, come on to the next line, and basically I'd be using here self dot start underscore time underscore button dot pack. Okay, the pack function is being used, and now what I just want here is that site is equal to tk dot that would be left. Now, what I just want is that whatever the like my cheek inter window has been made, I want this button to come onto the left side of that cheek inter window, right? So in that case here, I'm just adding the left. So the very first button, I just want to be coming here as a start button. So I just wrote here tk dot left. You can just change it to right as well, whatever you just wish afterwards. But right now, as you have just seen in the starting, the first button was start, then stop, then it was reset, and after that it was basically exit, right? So the start was at the left hand side, right? So I just want it to be here, so that is why I just wrote here tk dot left. Come on to the next line. So just let me go here this side. Okay, the start and good time button is done. Now next thing that I'll be doing is that for the stop one. So self dot, that would be stop underscore time underscore button. Okay, that is equal to, the procedure will absolutely remain same, only one thing will be changed, that is basically the text. Okay, so here we tk dot button bracket self comma. Now what text actually I just want, let's say text instead of pause, let's say I just want to write here stop. Okay, so it will be coming there as stop comma. I'll be putting a comma. What should be the height? So height will be remaining same, because I do not want one button to go larger, one button to be smaller, one to be wider. No, I do not want that thing, right? I want all the buttons that will be coming in a proper alignment, in a proper length, in a proper width, right? So in that case, I'll be giving all the parameters as same. Okay, this is done. After that, what about the font? So font is equal to, it will be Arial. The size would be 19, and even I just want it to be bold, right? And what about the color? Okay, what about the background color? So that would be background is equal to, and right, I just want the red color to come here. So background is equal to red. Okay, this is all. I'll be coming down, and here I'll be again using self dot start. Okay, that would be stop, right? Stop underscore time underscore button dot pack, and in the bracket I'll be passing here side is equal to, and that would be tk dot left, right? That is done. Now come on to the next line. Basically start and stop time, start and stop have been made here. Now it's the time for doing it for the reset one. Okay, so I'll be writing here self dot reset. Okay, that is reset underscore time underscore button. Okay, just one second, that is like this. Okay, so that is self dot reset underscore time underscore button. In that also we'll be writing here tk dot button into the bracket self will be passed comma. What about my text? So my text would be here that reset, right? So that would be reset like this. Okay, comma, height would absolutely be same that we have entered previously, that is 5. Width will absolutely be same that we had entered previously, that was 7. Font will also be absolutely remain same, that is basically my Arial. Okay, that is Arial. And size would be 19, and I just want it to be bold as well, right? And after that, basically what should be the background color? So I just want the background color to be yellow here for this. Okay, yellow. And after that, I'll be writing here, come on to the next line, self dot, and that would be reset underscore time underscore button dot pack, and here also the side would be is equal to tk dot left. Okay, that is done. Now other than this, I have my last button to be made, and that last button is actually my quit button. Okay, so that is self dot quit underscore button, right? That is equal to, here will be tk dot button into the bracket, I'll be writing here self comma. What should be my text? So my text should be quit. Okay, this quit will be my text, let's say. Fine. After this, basically what I just want is that I just want my height. So my height will be equal to 5, my width will be equal to 7. What about my font? So my font will be the same, that is basically the Arial comma, the size will be 19, and it would be bold, right? And after that, what I just want is that I just want my background color to come. So my background color is, let's say I want it to be in the blue color, right? So I just wrote that blue. Come on to the next line, and basically here I'll be writing self dot button and that would be quick underscore button dot pack, and in brother bracket it will again be that side is equal to, side is equal to, and that would be tk dot left, right? That is done. Now I'm just left with one thing inside this function, and that is I just want to give a particular title to my window that will be appearing. So that I'll be writing self dot window dot, and that would be title, self dot window dot title. Okay, so let me quickly correct out the spelling here for the window, and that is title here. And into the bracket I'll be writing here my title is, let's say, my own stop watch. Let's say this is the title which I just want to come here, right? So in that case, self.window.title, my own stop watch, right? So I hope that you had got a fair idea that what are the things that I'll be applying here, what are the things that I'd be writing here, right? So let's give it a try. Let me just now basically let me just quickly save it out and run this one, run this for once, and let's see that basically what happens. So the name for my is final stopwatch.py. Okay, so I'd be writing here, I'll be writing here Python, and the name for, Python, Python. Name for my file is, that is final and stop watch, final stop watch dot py, and just hit enter. So basically, you are able to see that my stopwatch has come, which I have made right now. If I click on start, if I click on stop, reset or quit, nothing is like happening here, nothing is working. Why? Because basically I haven't defined any functions for the start, stop, reset, and quit. I haven't given any things here, right? Till now, I have only and only made out my whole layout, that like what should be the color, what should be the buttons, how it should come. All those things I have done till now. Okay. Now the next task that comes is that we will be defining some several functions so as our stopwatch starts working for the start, for the stop, for reset, and for the quit as well. Right, so this is the second task that will be following. So come to the next line, and here I'll be defining one another function, and that function would be start underscore time. So def start underscore time, and in the bracket I'll be passing here as self. Okay, so basically my start time function, that will be basically starting out the time for me, right? In that case, I'll be firstly adding one condition that if not self dot running. If not self.running, I'll be putting out the colon here. So I'll be writing self.stopwatch_label dot after, and in the bracket I'll be giving out the exact value, that is 1000. After this, basically it is in the milliseconds actually, right? And I'll be writing here self.change. Self.change is actually one function in this, and I'll be writing here self.running is equal to true. Now let me explain that what actually I'm just writing here. So just come above and have a look that I had already, what I just written here is that I have written here running, right? So basically we had already defined a parameter, we had also already defined a variable that was running here, right? And we had given it a value which was false, right? So I had defined a parameter which was running and given it a value which was false, right? Now basically in the self.running, so if it will be if not false basically directly means that if my condition is true, then come inside this stopwatch label. So it means that start my stopwatch, basically start displaying the seconds, and after that basically change to this running. Okay, change this running variable which we had made to true, that basically my stopwatch is running, right? This is the whole idea which is about this function which we had written, right? Now let's make out the function for defining out the pause time. So I was just doing enter and writing here def pause underscore time. Okay, and in bracket it would be self. Okay, self. I'll be putting out the colon. Okay, so here self dot running would be, I just mentioned that as false, it would be here. Okay, so that would be, okay, it would be true actually. True, right? Fine. So def pause time is done. Now I'm writing here for the pause, and that is basically if self dot running. Okay, if self dot running, then basically what to do, if self dot running, then here I would be writing self dot stop watch. Okay, if self dot running is basically if false, right? If self dot stop watch underscore label. okay, dot after, okay, self dot stopwatch underscore label dot after underscore cancel. This is actually one function which we have here, and in the bracket I'll be passing here self dot new underscore time. This new underscore time is one of the variables which we have already made. So let me just go above and show you this new underscore time. So for now I have just kept it blank, right? So self dot new underscore time. So basically now here inside the pause time, what I have done, I have written if self dot running, that is, that has been made here as true, right? Sorry, false. Self dot running is actually referring to the false, right? Then self dot stopwatch underscore label after cancel, as soon as we just like put on the pause button, so just stop that for here only. And in the self dot, that is new underscore time variable, in new underscore time variable I have kept it blank. So in this it is blank, so because of that only it will just stop up the time at that particular place where you just click on that pause button, right? This is all which you need to do here, and after this I will be passing here that self parameter, and that would be self dot running, and that will be equal to false here. Okay, self dot running is equal to false. Come on to the next one. My next function that I'll be defining is the reset time. So that would be def reset underscore time, and in the bracket it would be self. I'll be putting out the colon. Come on to the next line. Now basically here what I'll be doing is that I'll be writing if self dot running. Okay, that is running. Okay, self dot running. Okay, just let me go above in self dot running. We already have this false, right? So if self dot running, come on to the next line. I'll be writing here self dot stopwatch underscore label. Okay, stopwatch underscore label, and in that again I would be writing here if so I'll be writing here dot after underscore cancel, dot after underscore cancel, the same function which we have used above. And in the bracket, I'll be writing here self dot new underscore time. So basically, it will reset out my whole of the time which we have given here, right? And basically, here inside it, I'll be writing self dot running. Okay, self dot running is equal to false. False like this, right? So this is basically about the reset time which we have given. Now after this I just need to give out some values, also some text that after, like, as soon as this functioning is performed, what to just display there. As soon as I click on that button, what to display on that stopwatch area, right, or the timer area. So I'd be writing here outside my if condition that self dot total underscore hours, the total underscore hours comma, that is self dot total underscore minutes. Okay, self dot total underscore hours, total underscore minutes, and that would be again, once again, that would be self dot total underscore seconds is equal to, I would be initializing all the three as 0, 0, 0. I'd be giving all the three the value as 0. So my parameters which I had already made, that was self dot total underscore hours, total underscore minutes, and total underscore seconds. I'm just giving it a condition as basically 0, 0. So initialize them as soon as the reset button is clicked. So initialize all of them as to 0, 0. And here I'd be writing self dot, and that would be stopwatch underscore label dot config. I'd be giving you here a configuration. That what text that would be, okay, one single I, and what text actually I just want here. So config is equal to text would be my 00:00:00, that is my standard format in which I just want my time to appear if I have not started my stopwatch, right? Now reset underscore time is done, fine. Now basically I have to make a function that is def underscore change. Okay, now that will basically hold all of my important functioning of the whole stopwatch. That will basically increasing the time, increasing the hour, increasing the minute, increasing the seconds, all those things, right? So in that I'd be writing here self dot total underscore seconds. First of all, I'd be taking this total underscore seconds, and I'd be applying that plus equal to 1. So I'm just incrementing that by 1, right? As soon as I start on that button, so it will start basically increasing. If now my condition goes here, if self dot total underscore seconds, okay, self dot total underscore seconds is equal to 60. if this condition is true, then what to do? Then I need to increment the minute, right? So I'd be writing here self dot total underscore minutes plus is equal to 1, right? So I just need to increase, increment the minute value. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, right? So as soon as the 60 seconds had completed, now I want the changement into my minute area, right? I just want it to be in 1 minute, and after that 1 minute, 1 second, 1 minute, 2 seconds, and goes on like this, right? So I just wrote that. Other than this, I'll be writing here myself dot, that will be self dot, and that would be total underscore seconds, that would be total underscore seconds is equal to 0. So I'd be initializing that as 0, right? Now basically my another condition goes that if self dot total underscore minutes is equal to 60. So 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour, right? So in that case, basically I'll be incrementing my total hour. So self dot total underscore hours, right? Total underscore hours parameter, and I'll be writing here plus is equal to 1. So I just incremented that thing, and I'll be making my minute here as 0. Okay, so self dot total underscore minutes is equal to 0, right? I just gave it the value as 0. Right, this thing is done. Now what I am just left here is that I need to just give out some if strings, and just I need to apply some another conditions as well, right? So coming out of my if condition, and now here I'll be starting. So I will be making a variable that is total underscore r. The total underscore r's are the same one which I'd be using. Underscore string I would be using here, okay? At total underscore r's underscore string. Now I'll be passing out the if string here. Now what are this actually if strings? So if strings are used whenever we just want to, whenever I just want to give some value in the middle of my sentence. Okay, let's say I'm just writing a sentence and I have a variable in which I have stored some value, and I want that value to appear in between that sentence. So in that case, basically we use the if strings. Okay, inside the if string, I would be writing here as, okay, so it will be writing here as self dot, and that would be total underscore hours. First for my hours, right? So self dot total underscore hours. My condition goes if, okay, if self dot total underscore hours is greater than 9. Okay, if this is greater than 9, then I'll be writing here else my if string goes, and it basically gives me self dot total self dot total underscore hours like this, right? So this is basically the the sentence which will be applying here. So self and basically, okay, this is gone here, right? Okay, let me just first of all go back like this, and let me just write here, okay, just let me remove this statement for a while, and let me move right here. Now what I'll be just doing is that I'll be first of all taking a self parameter self dot, and I'll be writing new underscore time, okay, self dot new underscore time, and that will be equal to self dot stopwatch underscore label dot after, okay, self dot stopwatch underscore label dot after, and in the bracket it will be the same value which I've just passed previously, that will be 1000 comma, and it will be self dot change the name for my function, okay, change is the name for my function. Now, just what I'll be doing is that I'll be passing these parameters, okay, this functions name which we had made inside this features, okay. Now, the buttons which we have made, that is my start, stop, reset, add, quit. The buttons which we had made inside this, I'll be adding one another parameter, that is command, and I would be writing out these here, okay. That is why I just was just saying that basically one parameter is left. Okay, so background green is done, and this green one is for my start. So in that I'd be writing here as command is equal to, and now my command is basically my function name, that is start underscore time, right? This is my command which I need to give into my start. Now this one is my stop one. So here I'd be giving my command is equal to, and that would be stop underscore, okay, that would be stop, and okay, just let me check out that what's the name for the function which we have made. So let's go downside and see here, that is pause underscore time. Okay, that is fine. Let me just go out like this here. Okay, so instead of this stop, I'd be writing here pause underscore time. Yes, this one. So this is my function name, right? After this yellow one was for the reset, right? So I'd be writing here command is equal to, and that I'd be writing here reset time. And this one for the quit. For this I'd be writing here command is equal. Okay, that is command is equal to, and I'd be writing here as change. Okay, this change function which we have made. Right, so this is the idea that I'd be adding some different commands here. So I had just made out all of these things. Okay, so okay, instead of that change, if I just directly write out here, let me just move out this change from here inside the command. I would write directly, I'd write self dot window dot quit. So this is actually a direct function which actually works here, and I just put on that direct function so that we just do not need to use out any other function here, right? Now, my next thing that comes is that I would be saving out my program here, that is control plus S, right? And now what I'll be just doing is that I'll be going on to my Windows PowerShell and, right here. And I'll be again writing out that thing which is Python, and that was final stopwatch.py, right? This was the name. Okay, so basically, it is saying me that start underscore time is not defined. Okay, let's check out. So, start underscore time is not defined. Let's see that what actually happens here and where we have this use out that start underscore time. Okay, just one second, that for using that start underscore time, I even need to apply the self also because we are just defining it inside the class. Right, so just let me quickly write out that thing. So, it would be here like self dot, okay, here also it would be self dot, and reset this semicolons will not come. Let me remove it from here as well, and this will also be self dot, and okay, so here I have just already used that self, right? So I would be again saving. Now just please make sure to always save your program before running, because the changes which you have made that do not save automatically, right? So that is control plus S. Okay, again go to Windows PowerShell and just run out my program. So this was my stopwatch, right? As soon as I click on this start, okay, as soon as I click on this start, it is not still working, right? Why it is not working? Because here I haven't defined the further conditions which I was writing right now, okay? So I just wrote that and I just erased that so that I can just let you know that why is the need for defining out that functions, that like statements which I am just gonna write now, okay? So just let's start up with the things, and I would be just coming backside here. Okay, let me give some tab spaces, correct tab spaces, right? Now, I'll be defining several conditions here that will be actually helpful for increasing my time and for making my time run on that particular watch will be coming, right? So, in that, I'll be writing that total underscore hours. Yes, this is my variable, total underscore hours that I'll be writing, and I'll be giving it an underscore string, okay? And I'll be applying out my condition which I was applying, that is if a string. Inside that, I'll be passing the self dot total underscore hours. Okay, self dot total underscore hours, right? Now, my condition goes if basically self dot total underscore hours is greater than 9. Okay, because if 9 is, basically it is greater than 9, then in that case, it need to take both of the values, that is 10, right? Firstly, what we have defined the text as 00:00:00, right? So till the time my hours, my minutes and my seconds are in one digit, then in that case basically we do not have any issue. But when my time, hour and seconds change to two digit, right, when my hour and my minutes change to two digits, then I need to add the things here, right? I need to apply some different conditions for making that visible on the stopwatch, okay? So that same thing I'm just doing here. So if self dot total underscore hours is greater than 9, so basically I'm writing here else, okay, I'm just using here shorthand if else. Basically this is a technique in Python which is called a shorthand if else. I'll be explaining the whole sentence in a while, just let me quickly put out that here. Okay, so that is if I'll be putting out here 0 and inside the bracket I'll be writing self dot, and that would be total underscore hours, right? So I'd be writing out like this. So let me just explain that what actually here it is happening. So if self dot total underscore hours is greater than 0, okay, if this is the condition, right, then my this statement, this if string will be executed, which I have written in the starting. Okay, just make sure that if my first condition is true, okay, just let me take my cursor. If this is true condition, then this will be executed. Okay, otherwise this else part will be executed, right? Fine. Now if my total number of hours is greater than 9, then in that case I just need to add on to that hours, right? Otherwise if this condition is not satisfied, then in the starting this 0 will be present, right? In that case only I have written this 0, that in the starting 0 will present, and after that 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 whatever the number of hour it is going on till 9, that will be coming, right? So this is the whole idea of the condition. Now the same conditions I will be applying for the minute as well. So give me the tab spaces here, right? That was okay, I'll be writing it here, not inside. Let me just make this self downside. Fine. So here I'll be again writing total underscore minutes, and I'll be writing here underscore string, another variable, okay, that is equal to if string, and I'll be putting out the brackets and my okay, firstly let me put out this this and then the brackets. So my condition goes inside break this, I'll be writing self dot, and it would be self dot total underscore minutes, right? Self dot total underscore minutes, and after this it would be if, and my condition goes if self dot total underscore minutes is greater than 9, okay, then this is the condition. Then what I need to print is, I need to print the self dot total underscore minutes, but I need to add my else condition as well. Else, the else thus it would be same if string. I'll be writing here as 0, first of all this quotes, then 0, and then the bracket, right? And inside this it would be it would be self dot total underscore minutes, right? So I'll be again explaining you this minutes one, that what actually I'm doing. So here, as soon as my minutes becomes larger than 9, so larger than 9 it will be covering two spaces, right? Not only one place, it will be covering two spaces. So in that two space I need that this if string should come, that is self dot total underscore minutes. Okay, other than that, basically if this is not the condition, then in the starting 0 will come as it is going, and basically after that my minute will come, that basically what minute is it right now, right? This is the whole idea for this thing. Now the same procedure I'll be going out and following it for the seconds as well. So that would be total underscore seconds underscore string, and I'll be writing here is equal to if string. Now that would be in the bracket, I'll be writing here self, okay, self dot total underscore seconds, okay, and after this I'll be applying out my condition that if, okay, my condition goes that if self dot total underscore seconds, okay, if self, okay, just one second, let me show you that thing here, right? If self dot total underscore seconds is greater than 9, what you need to do is that we had already written it here, right? We had already written self dot total underscore seconds. But if this condition is not true, okay, if this is not the true condition, else I'll be writing that same if string inside the bracket here 0, then I'll be putting out the bracket, and in that so I need to write that self dot total underscore second, right? This is the idea, and let's come down. Now this is my last line that I'll be writing out for my code, that is basically displaying my time. Okay, so let me go here like this and let me start writing that things. So right here it would be coming, I'll be writing here one more line, self dot, okay, let me just come down and then write it. So it will be self dot, it is stopwatch underscore label, okay, self dot stopwatch underscore label dot config. I'd be applying my configurations here, right? Config in the bracket, it would be text is equal to, okay, text is equal to total R settings, okay, total R string, okay, that's not a setting, that is a string, okay. Now I would add that basically the plus sign, okay, I would be basically in between the colon will be coming, right? So that colon will come. Other than that, basically what will be coming, so other than that we will again be having that here I'd be applying that plus sign. Now what I just want to appear, I just want to appear my total underscore minutes underscore string, first hour then minutes, okay, then again I'll be putting a plus sign, and in between I want the colon, right? Again my plus sign goes here like this, and after this I want my total underscore second underscore string to come, Right, so I've just written all of those things here, right? Now after that, sev.new_time, and inside that I had already written sev.change, right? Now it's the time for saving out my program, and let's run it basically, and let's see that basically what output actually we are getting. Here I'd be doing the Ctrl+S, and I'd be going on to my PowerShell. Okay, firstly let me just clear out this whatever we had just written. Write this, and here we just go out with the program. So yes, this is my watch which is coming. If I just click on the start button, so basically you just have a look that it has started appearing. My my seconds have started moving here. Now here I'd be just explaining you a little bit about that what we had done. So this thing, the start, stop and reset, quit, okay, these buttons are actually appearing because of this, right? Because of these features it is appearing, right? These different colors are appearing because of these features. After that, this time we had already given a particular text here, right? My text was, let me just go above and show you that where we had written. So I have given a particular, that is 00:00:00. I have given that, right? So because of that, it is appearing in this format, right? Other than that, here I have given several conditions that if my time is basically greater than 0 or basically greater than 9 and all those things. So just increment. And here my final thing is that text is equal to, and I have just added all those things and run my program. So basically here you'll be able to see that after 57, 58, 59 and 60, my already time has changed to 1, then 1, 2, 3, and it will basically go up to again 60. Then minutes will again become 2. Then again we'll go to 60. So this procedure will continue till we get 59 minutes. So as soon as my 59 minutes have been completed, it will change it to 1 hour, then 1 hour, 1 minute, and then somewhat seconds, then 1 hour, 2 minutes, somewhat seconds, and it will go on like this. Now if we just click on my stop button, so you are able to see that basically here my time has been stopped, right? If I click on the reset, so my whole time has been reset, right? Previously it was 1:25, but now my time has been reset. And if I just click on quit, so my program has been, like, the output has been closed here, right? So this was a kind of a stopwatch which we can make, and this was a wonderful project which I hope that you liked. And this was a kind of a stopwatch which you can just make with the help of the Tkinter window, right? So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and take care.